Hello, welcome back to Let's Play King's Quest III to Heir as Human. We have some time. The wizard's on a journey, I believe. He's always either doing that or sleeping. Not only did we see something in-game, the last episode or the one before, but one of the few things I remember about this game is that there is a secret laboratory or of some sorts underneath. I believe in this room.
Carefully examining the bookshelf, you notice something unusual about one of the volumes. Only the spines are apparent, and they seem to be stuck together.
See, I didn't even click on it. It was actually on the side, so you can click anywhere on the bookcase and this will come up. What does this say? Insult? Fight fire with fire. Eh, can't read it all. Maybe if I had it on a lower resolution. Oh, great.
There are 5 levers arranged in a row. You have a feeling random selection won't help you.
Probably not. What is this?
You scan the bookshelf.
Oh.
Every
I thought something was on the floor there. See that?
So many books line.
Yeah, never mind. Okay. Ooh, we have to go back up top. Those symbols match symbols we found in that book. Do we take that with us? I really hope so, otherwise we have to go back there. Ah, I'm trying to click here. Alright. Let's go look at our stash here. Okay, I believe it's this book. Select to take. Done.
You feel strange. You feel strange knowing your predecessor left this, and that a later Gwydion might find it.
Not unless you put a stop to this wizard once and for all. Okay.
The rest of the rest.
Okay, so we go this way. Okay. I could take the book with me, sure, but so it's one of these weird, like, almost looks like, I don't know, a person on his side with no head. So, if you wonder what I'm doing now, I'm just dash, 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 and dash. I'm writing this out. I'm drawing this out, rather. So just bear with me. This is some kind of weird, like, I don't know, a snakey symbol. Okay.
The rest of the page.
Sure, we're gonna find more contraband items down there, so I don't think I have to put the book back. Okay. I see these two symbols. Oh, and there's dash. You know, I thought the dash was like, you know, hidden symbols that, you know, you gotta fill in. So it's actually pretty good. So it's this, and then three times. This dash. And another dash. One might be to open, one might be to close, but let me do them all for now. I already started anyway. Two of these kind of infinity sort of symbols, and then this one. Ah, automatically. Sweet!
The trapdoor is open and awaiting your descent. The trap.
Okay.
You quickly pull the levers in the correct sequence.
I closed it. Ah!
Every surf.
I didn't mean to close it. I was going to click on it to go down.
You quickly pull.
Okay, good. Automatically. So, let's do this. Nice.
You are on a flight of steep underground stone steps. They curve downward toward a dim light. The open trap door is above you. The ceiling is made of very thick wood. Several strong pillars support the ceiling. The steps are made of narrow, rough stones, crudely constructed.
Okay. Continuing on our journey. Nice.
You look in awe around this torchlit underground room. It appears to be a laboratory. A wizard's laboratory.
A wizard's laboratory.
The narrow stone steps lead up to the wizard's study. The burning torches throw flickering shadows across the walls, making the room even more ominous. Perhaps this was Manannan's previous pet. The shelves are filled with numerous items. The shelves hold skeletons of small animals and birds, some human skulls and bones, and other odd instruments whose use you do not know.
But perhaps we will find out.
The wizard has a desk and stools sitting in the corner. There is a chest sitting next to the shelves. There is nothing that looks awfully useful on that desk.
Alright, nothing we can do there?
It's locked.
Locked. I did find a key earlier, so I'd have to go back and get that. That's the thing, I'm always stashing items.
The boxes are sealed tight.
So, we don't always have our inventory items when we need them.
Some boxes lie next to the shelves. Most of the bottles are unmarked. There are a few things that interest you, though.
Like what?
Most of the
I click on everything?
Most of
what interests me? Ouch.
You pick up the bottle labeled ground fish scales and take it with you.
Ground fish scales, huh?
Within the glass container, you see your ground scales. The powder emits a faint fishy smell. They just give you a stomach ache and bad breath.
Yeah, cat breath. Alright, what else interests me? Anything?
You pick up the empty flask and take it with you.
Okay, and I got an empty flask.
It's just an empty container. You could put something inside it.
I sure could, wise guy.
You can't drink from an empty container.
I kinda know that.
You pick up the bottle labeled toad spittle and take it with you.
Toad spittle? Ugh.
Toad spittle is unpleasant stuff, to say the least.
Oh yeah.
The thought turns your stomach. You pick up the bottle labeled toadstool powder and take it with you.
Okay, so you have a bunch of reagents. Ingredients for spells.
The cream-colored toadstool powder is finely textured and nearly odorless.
I drank it.
This tastes pretty good, you think. You'd eat more, but you're too busy dying. Didn't you read the warning label?
I didn't know there was a warning label on it. Okay, so I gotta go back. This shouldn't take too long. I always felt like the cat was watching me in the first game, like reporting back.
Carefully examine.
Interesting, the two of these symbols aren't used at all. Okay, I guess I gotta click here and then there.
You pick up the empty. You pick up the bottle. You pick up the bottle.
Does it have a warning label?
The cream colored to.
I don't see any warning label.
You pick up the bottle labeled saffron and take it with you.
Saffron, huh?
Inside the jar, you see the saffron, an orange-yellow powdery substance.
Now, before I poke this thing, I just save here. If I can hit the right menu, it'd be a good thing.
It isn't meant to be eaten on its own.
Okay.
You pick up the bottle labeled nightshade juice and take it with you.
Nightshade juice. Pretty cool.
The nightshade juice sloshes around inside the glass jar.
I drank it.
Oops. Bad move.
So some things will let me drink.
Didn't you read the warning label?
And others not.
You pick up the box. You pick up the bottle label.
And fish scales.
Most of the.
Stuff better. I hope the wizard doesn't most notice this stuff missing. Okay. About this stuff.
You're not really into collecting fossils and the like. Some things are better left upon the shelf.
What about this bottle?
You're not.
No.
Though you're not a wizard, you know better than to go poking around at such things randomly. This is dangerous stuff.
Yeah.
There is nothing.
Okay. Take a look at this stuff.
Numerous items are strewn about the desk. It's apparent that the wizard doesn't clean down here.
A ring.
Atop the oak table are a large leather-bound book, a mortar and pestle, a little brazier holding charcoal, a flint, measuring cups, beakers, flasks, and stirrers.
All the implements necessary.
Numerous items. You look in awe.
Okay, so.
Though you're not. You take a closer look at the wizard's work table.
Cool. Just like in King's Quest II, we got a close-up look of the wizard's table.
Good wood used for bad practice. This is where the wicked wizard whiles away his time. The mortar and pestle await the magic of muscle power. A charcoal brazier sits on the desk. The flint is used for lighting the brazier.
Looks like a wrench.
Covered with gold trimmings, the old book's leather cover is cracked and worn, its pages yellowed and brittle. The title, however, is clear: The Sorcery of Old. You eagerly thumb through page after page of what you assume to be magic formulas. The ink of the old handwriting is faint and barely readable. Most of the formulas are indecipherable, but a few are in a language you know. You treat the old book with great care. As you can tell, it contains recipes for some very old and powerful magic spells. Your hands shake as you realize this book could be the key to your escape from the evil Manannan.
Oh, yes. Understanding the language of creatures. Pour one thimbleful of dew into a bowl. Okay, I need dew. So I'm gonna get dew from outside somewhere. Place one tuft of fur from any animal into a bowl. We have the cat fur. Add one rounded spoonful of ground fish scales. Have that. Place one dried reptile skin into the bowl. Dried reptile skin. Now I'm just writing down the items that we're gonna have to collect from the land outside here. Drop one small feather from any bird into the bowl. I might have a feather. I'm not sure. I don't remember all our items. Feather? Question mark? Mix bowl's contents with your hands until they become doughy. Recite the following: fur of beast and reptile skin with scale and feather too thrown in. Grant me sense to comprehend animals of water, earth, and wind. Wave a magic wand over bowl. Separate dough into two pieces and place in ears. Huh. Interesting. Oh, and then you can recite the spell. Flying like an eagle or a fly. Okay. Well, this is understand language. That's what we're going to need for that. Okay, so this is a flight spell. So I'm going to use up all my time just reading and writing this stuff down. Put one pinch of saffron into a jar of rose petal essence. Do I have rose petal essence? No, I have saffron, just got that. Recite the following: spirits of air, cloud, and breeze, lend me your wings that I may seize the opportunity to fly. Allow me passage through the sky. Wave a magic wand over the jar of essence. I need a wand. To activate the spell at a later time, dip an eagle feather. Okay. I know where an eagle is. So to get its feather. Into the essence if you wish to become an eagle. Dip a pair of fly wings into the essence if you wish to become a fly. We have fly wings. To return to your own form, recite the following verse. So ends my fun, my flight's now done. Teleportation. Okay. Grain one spoonful of salt grains with a mortar and pestle. Grind one sprig of dried mistletoe in the mortar. Okay, we have mistletoe. Have to dry it somehow? Put it in the sun, maybe? Rub one smooth stone of unusual color in the texture. Okay. Gotta look around for an unusual colored stone. And kiss the stone. Smooth colored stone. Recite the following: my kiss so tender I now give so that I may have a chance to live. Seeking a place of trouble less when my smooth stone I shall caress. Wave a magic wand over the stone. To cast a spell, rub the stone. Alright, so give me a quick way to get away from Manannan. Causing a deep sleep to bestow upon Manannan. So it's a sleep spell. Grind three acorns. Got those with a mortar and pestle. Put acorn powder in a bowl. Put one cup of nightshade juice, I have that, in the bowl. Stir the mixture with a spoon. I have a spoon. Light a charcoal brazier. I need a way to light it. Boil the mixture until the nightshade juice is almost gone. Remove the mixture from heat. Spread mixture on table and wait until dry. Recite the following. Acorn nightshade together mixed, concoction of a deep sleep fixed. From places of much lesser light you bring to them a longer night. Wave a magic wand over the powder. We still need a wand for that. Put the powder in a pouch for safekeeping. I don't know if we actually need a pouch or he can just stick it in his pocket. Enhancing musical talent so we can get the loot and maybe give it to that poet. This is a useful concoction for the more musical of the magically inclined. Add one sandful of hot, dry sand. Okay. Musical talent. Sand. To a glass flask soap, fill with seawater. Seawater in flask. Place one handful of fertile soil to the flask. Shake the flask. I'm writing fertile soul. Shake the flask to mix the contents thoroughly. Wave a magic wand over the flask. Recite the following. Earth-bearing fruit from one's toiling hands with patience of timeless swift sifting sands. Swirl through endurance, soak salty with peas. Permit me to please all musically. This draft comes in handy at functions when the entertainment is poor or non-existent. Administer just prior to the event and prepare for one memorable performance. Brewing a storm. How many spells are there? Make storm. Ocean water? What's the difference between ocean water and seawater? Maybe nothing. Light charcoal brazier, slowly heat bowl. Do not boil, then remove. Put one spoonful of mud into the bowl. Add one pinch of toadstool powder to the bowl. We have that. Blow into the hot brew. Recite the following. From nature... Yeah, I'm going to come back to this. Because we're in the yellow now. Oh, God. This is no time for falling off stairs. Should be fine. What's up with the cat? The cat's in there.
You are not...
I have to... He's gonna be looking for his cat, isn't he?
You are not...
How do I get up there?
You are not...
I can't get to him, right? So... Oh, this might undo us, but... Oh, God.
You scan the books...
No! These.
You quickly pull the lead.
Okay, the cat left anyway. You delayed me, cat! Gotta get up to my room. He'll, like, poof in any second. Come on. Once I get in my room, I'm safe. Okay, thank God. So what I know, he won't come in here. So I gotta hide all this stuff. Select to hide. Let's hide the stuff we don't need. God, guys. You won't believe that. It was pretty tense there. Let me just double check. Yeah, I don't have anything I'll need. So what was that cat up to? I thought I had to get him out of there. Do-do-do. Pacing, waiting for the master. I could just put him to sleep for like a minute.
Dun-dun. I am hungry. Prepare me a meal at once.
I don't think I have any food, guy. What do we do if there's no food? I'll check the kitchen.
Manannan is impatient.
Yeah, he's impatient.
There's no. Many.
There's no more food.
You are not.
Unless you want to eat your cat.
There's nothing under the table. There's no hole. There's no hole in this bucket. You'd like. Many.
Narrator guy?
This is the kitchen of the wizard's house. Other than your own bedchamber, this is the only place in the house that you feel you can call your own.
Can I tell him there's no food?
Manannan isn't.
I can't make food that isn't here, guy.
Master?
Don't jabber at me, boy. Bring me my food now.
There is none. I don't have any food.
You're awfully thick-headed, aren't you? It seems you need to be taught a lesson or two about obeying. Perhaps you'd like a closer view of the ground.
You gonna put me upside down?
Suddenly, you feel squishy and slimy, with an awful weight on your back. Your tentacled eyes swivel around to see your shell. Oh no, he's turned you into a snail!
Yeah, I can still walk around. Oh, I'm not dead at this point. Okay. When he turned me into a frog, that was it.
The wizard has transformed you into a small, slimy mollusk. This is where Manannan eats his meat.
So I just gotta put up with this, because I have no food to give him.
The wizard...
I can't grab anything, because I don't have any hands. Excuse me, guys. The life of a snail is great indeed. It's great indeed. You need to be hungry, dude, because you have to keep turning me into things, because if there's food around here, I don't know where it is.
Manannan helps himself.
There
are various.
He helps himself to his own beverages. I don't know where else to get some food from. I already gave him the porridge. Maybe I have to go back to the Three Bears house and get more porridge? That's possible. Here he is.
I am going to lie down for a rest. Do not disturb me.
I'll try not to. You and your rests and journeys. Actually, still have more of that book to read. Alright, guys. Well, next time. Thanks for watching, and see you next time. We'll go back down to the lab and read the rest of that book. Alright, bye-bye.